Welcome back to Wine and Winds. I'm your host, KP. Many of you know me as a marine biologist with a lot of experience training animals like seals, sea lions, and sea otters. But you may not know that many of those animals were rescued and rehabilitated. So today, we're going to take a deeper dive into the hows and whys of marine mammal rescue. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and head down to the descriptions for ways that you can help the channel. Now, there are a lot of reasons that an animal might be in need of rescue. The most urgent is probably injury. And I've worked with a variety of marine mammals that have suffered from gunshot wounds, many of which to the face, leaving them blind. The most common marine mammals in need of rescue are actually pups separated from their mothers in one way or another. There can be many reasons that this happens. Predators, for example, who may have attacked the mother or chased her off, but an unfortunately high number of separations are caused by human interference. Now, it's very important to understand that all marine mammals are protected by the Marine Mammal Protection Act. Signed into law in 1973, the Marine Mammal Protection Act makes it illegal to hunt, kill, harass, capture, or attempt to do so with any marine mammal. This is important to remember if you ever see a marine mammal that you think might be in need of rescue. Because that may not be the case, and attempting to rescue an animal yourself could not only be dangerous to you and the animal, but it could also cause legal action against you. The right thing to do in case you ever find yourself looking at a marine mammal you think needs rescue is to call the experts. Many times that would be a local zoo or an aquarium that you know has a rescue center. Many do, including the Vancouver Aquarium, the Monterey Bay Aquarium, and even the Alaska Sea Life Center. They will then call the authorities, such as the Department of Fisheries and Oceans here in Canada, or the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration in the US. You could also call these government agencies yourself, and they will then get in contact with the specialists that are needed. And the first step these experts will take is simply observation. They'll sometimes spend up to 24 hours observing a single animal to make sure that it needs rescue. Especially if that animal is a pup.
How are you?
Often, seal or sea otter mothers will leave their pups for periods of time while they're foraging for food. So we really want to be absolutely positive that an animal has been truly abandoned before stepping in, intervening, and rescuing. And in all these cases, it's not the marine biologist or the vet staff that makes these calls. Whether an animal is rescued or not is entirely up to those government agencies, the DFO or the NOAA. Once that determination is made and an animal is rescued, they are usually transported to the Rescue and Rehabilitation Facility, where they are given 24-hour care. What type of care and treatment that the animal gets depends largely on the reason that it was rescued in the first place. Abandoned pups are often malnourished and in need of food and fluids, while injured animals may need completely different treatments. The treatment can also be largely dependent on the animal's species. Seal pups are typically weaned at around 3 to 4 weeks from their mother. This means that they are often excellent candidates for release. Sea otters, on the other hand, will stay with their mothers for around 6 months, learning a lot of really important skills, like how to forage for food and how to groom their fur coats.
We have to groom them.
Ultimately, the decision to release an animal is not up to the staff at the rescue or rehabilitation facility. It's up to those same government agencies. The DFO and the NOAA will assess the animal and determine whether or not it's a good candidate for release.
Good.
Once that determination is made, the animal is either released back into the ocean, often in an area where there is a high population of that species, or perhaps right where it was rescued in the first place. Or if the animal is non-releasable, they can find a permanent home at a zoo or an aquarium. Now, it's always the goal to release every animal that we rescue, but it's not always possible. And it's important to remember that animals in zoos and aquariums live long, healthy lives and are ambassadors for their species. For more information, head down to the descriptions below where I've provided links for those government agencies as well as rescue centers that may be near you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and of course, head over to my Twitch channel where we have live discussions about all things marine mammal.